All right. Well, before we get to Todd Gurley, let's finish up with the Bucs here. Got a couple ancillary pieces to talk about for a second. We're talking about
ancillary.
The third wide receiver on this team. Not sure who it's going to be. Justin Watson is a guy most of you probably know about. We've name dropped him last offseason. Someone you might want to take a flyer on. He had a hamstring strain.
Oh, that was a weak pop.
That was a real weak
Maybe
pop.
Maybe the weakest ever.
You were still concentrating on ancillary. Maybe Jay Wayne's doing like a word a day.
That's what that pop was.
Very ancillary pop.
So he had a hamstring strain that caused him to miss most of the offseason last year.
I'm going to chug this one, get another one.
Okay. There's not much you can find on Watson from a film standpoint. I found one 8-minute video of the final drive of Penn University versus Cornell. It's a 97-yard drive.
What was Cornell, the Bears?
Cornell, maybe. And in that game, I watched that final drive. Watson was all over the field for them, making big catches, working the sideline with a nice toe drag, showing good body control, laying out to make a diving catch. But, I mean, you can't really find anything else to watch besides some pro day footage. He did get snubbed from the combine, but then showed out at his pro day running a 4.4 40 and a 40-inch vertical, which had everybody all giddy. He's got solid size, 6'2", 215, and really long arms, 33 inches and 3/4. Other metrics, strong college dominator.
Yeah, he was a darling of the late round kind of metric guys. I put him on a bunch of taxi squads last year, so I'm excited if Justin Watson could become a thing.
Yep, 286 catches for 3,777 yards and 33 touchdowns in college. So 98th percentile college dominator, but playing in the Ivy League.
Yeah,
and then an 81 percentile breakout age. So you got to like that if you're into the metrics. Another thing here is he's got a brother that has cerebral palsy, who's kind of his driving motivation. And anytime his practice gets hard, Tampa Bay Heat, he's like blisters on his feet. He just thinks to himself about his brother who can't walk and talk, and he starts laughing to himself like, "I don't have it bad.
Yeah,
my brother has it bad." And like, so anytime you got a guy with athleticism and size and work ethic and motivation, it's a good combination.
Penn Quaker, that's Ivy League, right?
And he's got an ADP of 222. Smart so. Guy. Why not put him on your team in deep bench leagues?
Yeah, I put him on. I added him in rookie drafts at the ends if I could last year on deeper ones, and then just waited for the waivers to clear and threw him on the bottom of some benches.
Perriman is dealing with a shoulder injury. He's missing OTAs.
Sure.
And then
they're
I read
giving him a little bit of love.
He was running with the ones.
Woo.
Justin Watson, that is, was running with the ones in Woo. Perriman's absence.
Yeah.
So got to like that.
Couldn't beat out Perriman.
Maybe he will now.
Yeah. Perriman's out till training camp.
I don't know. Possibly. He's just sidelining. It's been a couple weeks, so he's always hurt. Anyway, you guys got anything more on Justin Watson?
Nothing on Justin Watson. They got old Scott Miller from Bowling Green, fast little fellow that received some praise from Bruce Arians, saying that he sees some John Brown in him or J.J. Nelson, one of those fast guys that he had on his team. So he could be a late round, super deep bench kind of scoop up. Other than that, I think Anthony Johnson's a guy from Buffalo that they picked up as an undrafted free agent.
Yeah,
And they also signed DeMarcus Lodge from
Ole Miss.
Ole Miss,
sort of the lost, forgotten man there.
Yeah, some people really liked him.
I mean, his good is pretty good. If you watch the highlight tape, you're like, dang, why didn't this guy get drafted? You're kind of surprised when you watch a couple, individual games. You see some of the holes in his game. There's good stuff. There's bad stuff. He's got some really nice contested catches and some good body contortion and going outside of his frame to make some really ridiculous, wow catches. Yeah. But then he's got a lot of drops like a lot of these rookie wide receivers do.
He's just a project chick.
He's got some good footwork along the sideline, a lot of like toe tapping and dragging. Yeah. Bunch of nice plays. It seemed a little faster than his 4.55 speed.
He likes to dance around the sidelines.
Yeah.
That's his move.
But, he's not going to take the lid off. He's not, like, electrifying or anything, and he wasn't asked to run many routes, so he's got some learning curve. But good interview, seems to work hard, so keep your eye on him. Star him up a little bit. Maybe breaks a squad, maybe not. But